All right, so this is the second video of our weekend wildcard Sunday. If you are just joining, know that there is that very first video because we're already on our 50th minute. So I'll give people just a little bit of a chance to join back in. We're down to our 50th minute, so it was like kind of extra to do this extra video, but why not? It's Sunday. Our last minute is second position Gamukha arm switch. So Gamukha is this whole business. I know Molly, you've done this with me. You're gonna do this without touching your back in that second position. So we've done second position multiple times today, heels in, toes out. And we're simply gonna switch out our arms, one elbow up, one elbow down without touching your back. Get ready in 3, 2, 1, let's begin. So, really finding some flexibility, some mobility of our shoulders. Stay strong through your core. And again, don't worry about how fast you go with these. See if you can almost touch your fingers toward each other. Breathe. And while we're in this second position, pull your navel in even tighter. Upright your spine. Lift your chin away from your chest. Breathe. You have last 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, release. Very nice. Well, now we have this whole video ahead of us, so let's do some proper stretching then. Keep your left leg in front. Good job, by the way. It feels like very anticlimactic because we just did that final minute, but here we go. Left leg in front, right leg. You can bring it as far back as feels comfortable for you. Square yourself off toward your left leg and then hinge from there. So you can keep your fingers kind of positioned in any way, either here, 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 wherever you like them to be. I want you to open up your chest though, so your front body has no like gaps, holes relative to your lower body. You're fairly flat. Glued over. Flex this left foot back toward your face. Breathe. Open your chest, square off your shoulders. Mm-hmm. And from here, let's just take this left arm and slide it perpendicular to our left leg. Open your chest and find your side body stretch. Lengthen, lengthen. And gently release, come back up. We'll do one either half split or you can move into your full split from here. So half split, you'll just tuck this right knee under you, right? Push your right hip slight forward, draw your left hip slight back, open your chest and again, hinge forward. You can also send your arms back behind, go for that really flat spine. Or alternatively, you tuck your back toes in, straighten out both of your legs, continue to push this right hip forward, and then start to separate your feet. I like to keep my back toes tucked, just so that it's not so easy for me to default and collapse with open hips. All right, so square hips, I let my top of my right thigh face the floor as I gently ease my way into these splits. Chest up. And let yourself feel this with, again, the top of your right thigh very deliberately facing the floor rather than your inner thigh facing the floor. Hold for 3, 2, 1. Use your hands to push yourself back up. We'll move through this half split. Hands go inside of your left leg. Swing it back and we'll switch it out. So let's sit back down, your right leg in front of you. And send this left knee back as far as you like. Square yourself off over your right leg and then hinge forward. I know my fingers are like super random right now, but I kind of like this position. I don't know, it feels really supported. So wherever feels good to you, you want to go for a flat upper body over your lower body. So just like you're trying to seal food, you know, with like a vacuum seal, or you're sealing your coffee beans. Like I just bought a huge big bag of 2-pound coffee beans. You want to keep oxygen out of it. That's how I want you to feel. Your upper body is sealed over your lower body, so you stay fresh, just like your coffee beans, and you get that nice flat upper body over your lower body. Good, gently come up out of it. Your right arm, get it perpendicular to your right leg and reach your left arm up and over. Flex your right foot back toward your face. Think of getting your chest even face up toward the ceiling. And gently come back up. Good. We'll move into, again, half split, so you can tuck your left knee underneath you. Draw your right hip back. Push your left hip forward, so you're in half split like this. And hinge to really get a nice long spine, to bend your arms however you like it, maintain the length in your spine. Or you go into your full split. So from this angle, you might be able to see a little bit better. I like the tucked toes just to keep the top of my thigh moving in the correct direction, right? So sending in the right trajectory of left thigh facing the floor as opposed to inner thigh facing the floor. Lift up tall through your chest. Mm-hmm. Continue to draw your right hip back. Continue to push your left hip forward for four, three, two, good. Push yourself up. Hands on inside of your right leg. Swing your right leg back behind you. Good, let's take a couple breaths here. Knees together, inhale, arms go all the way up. Exhale, push it out. Do that once again, inhale, arms go all the way up. Exhale, push it out, right, left, down. So good. Thank you for working out with me this International Yoga Day, kind of doing a hybrid workout of some inspired moves or derived moves from the yoga stuff. So thanks for playing along. And especially if you had never really thought about taking a yoga class, hopefully, maybe you were baited into potentially doing another one sometime in the future. Well, have a wonderful rest of your evening. I know it's not easy making it in on a weekend, so I thank you for your time. Thanks for being here. You guys are amazing, wonderful, and keep it up. I will see you tomorrow. We are back on for our normal, regular schedule of core, 30 minutes, no big deal. So I will see you then. Have a great evening. Hydrate well. Be good. Okay, bye.